brings us to the first game of the 2014 LCS Summer Playoffs as the Supa Hot Crew take on Roccat. The winner of this game, as we said before, will go on to face the second seed in the semi-finals, Fnatic. Now, the Supa Hot Crew have really gone from strength to strength over the year, and despite having their fair share of roster changes and problems, they managed to take the third seed coming into the playoffs.
And it's very impressive when you consider the fact they moved from being number 7 and relegated last split to now being number 3 and top seed in the quarterfinals towards Worlds here. So impressive improvement from Supa Hot Crew as a team. And yeah, they had some changes, but they all paid off. Like getting Kasing for support, Selfie for the mid lane, and of course the coaches to help the team throughout the season, all paid off for them here. They have great talent. But we have seen in the season that the team can be very inconsistent, which is normal for a young team, but there's no room for mistakes if they do want to qualify for Worlds.
And on the other side, we have Roccat, who managed a very impressive third place in the Spring Split playoffs, beating Alliance, actually, to secure that spot. And I think we can safely say that the league has just gotten stronger over the last few months, and that shows with Roccat's sixth place finish in the split this time around.
And they've changed their play style a little bit coming into the split here. They now favor this very slow and safe style of play. Roccat, they have the lowest amount of kills in the league as a team with 278. Compared to Millennium, who have the highest at 467, it's a massive difference. And Roccat clearly has issues picking up kills. Celebar and Overpower have picked up 80 kills each. Lowest for AD carry and second lowest for mid laners. And just to compare it, Reckless alone has 167 kills, more than these two combined here. So as there's no clear star player on Roccat, the entire team has to perform if they want to win.
So let's take a closer look then at the two teams and compare in-depth each role, starting in the top lane where Mimer meets Zazzus.
So last split, I would have put this matchup in favor of Zazzus, who had a great first split while Mimer had a very hard time on Supa Hot Crew. But now it's the other way around. Mimer has looked fantastic this split and is currently, in my opinion, one of the best top laners in Europe, while Zazzus has actually struggled.
And in the jungle, it's of course Impaler versus Jankos. We've seen time and time again how Jankos can get his team rolling with First Bloods. In fact, his 12 First Bloods over the season are a stark contrast to Impaler's 4, which could really make an impact in this best of 5.
Completely insane stats from Jankos, always at the right place in the early game. But in the mid lane, we have two very different players. Selfie, he's the aggressive type who will constantly look for kills or plays. Sometimes it backfires. While Overpower has been favoring the more passive approach until he was either strong enough to teamfight or split push before he actually did anything on the map.
And there's a pretty big difference in the KDAs of the AD carries. Mr. Rawls been quiet overall, but still managed to land in second position when it comes to EU AD carries KDA. Selfie is struggling behind and only managed to land in 7th. But we have to say he's definitely stepped up in recent weeks and he's definitely looking better as
100%
well.
100% agrees. Corki has been very, very good the last few weeks. On the supports, Kasing and Vander, two very similar players to be honest. Stat-wise, they follow each other. There's only 0.12 KDA between them. And Morgana has been the top pick for both of these supports here. We have, however, seen both of them shine on Thresh and make some big plays, but it definitely favored Morgana lately.
So as we move then towards champion select and a new patch here this week, what are we expecting to see?
So Lucian is back. He's been gone for a few weeks now. Both AD carries used to play him a lot. Most play champion, but pretty much for everyone in Europe, so no surprise. Mm. I expect to see him being played with the new E now, where lower cooldown, you reduce it when you auto attack. Yes, his range is shorter, but because of the E, he's still very safe and you can still blind pick him. Landing phase not as strong as we normally see. You need to be a bit more aggressive in it for it to work. But still, Celebar, I definitely expect to actually pick it up here. And then I looked at picks and bans for both teams. And Roccat, they prefer also to pick this very mid-game focused comp which relies on team fighting and safe control style. So I actually expect Supa Hot Crew to come in here, put a lot of focus on maybe some pick comps where they can try and split up Roccat here, surprise them, because Roccat as a team have said it themselves, they don't like to play in situations they are not used to or situations they didn't expect to be in. So I actually do predict or expect Supa Hot Crew to try and surprise them a little bit. And then maybe we could see Roccat leave something like Yasuo open for Selfie and try and counterpick with like a Zillion for Overpower in the mid lane.
Well, best of 5, there's certainly lots of different combos that we could see coming out today. And with a week to get ready for just one opponent, let's see how both of these teams have prepared themselves for this all-important best of 5.
Obviously, Worlds is the most important thing about this whole year, and it's everything we've been working for.
We've trained for like 6 months to get to the world, so now we need to do it.
I'm pretty proud of what we have accomplished in the second split at least. Like going from 7th place to 3rd place is a pretty big accomplishment.
We are not happy by how the season went for us, but now is the chance for us to show a better performance and change the results we
have. We have to remain motivated now. I mean, we kind of dropped our focus for a bit and we got 0-2 in the first part of the Super Week. But now I think everyone's more motivated than ever.
The main carry on Roccat is definitely that younger Yankers. He is either winning the whole game alone or losing the whole game alone.
I think we just need to shut down Selfie because he's the playmaker, and when he's doing well, everyone is doing well.
I'm pretty confident that Selfie's the better Polish mid laner, so he's going to come in strong. We're going to play very mid-centric, and me and him are going to be the best we can be for that 2v2.
They will try to 2 versus 2 us, versus like me and Overpower, because we usually play like that. But I'm not sure yet, maybe we'll change some tactic or we'll do something different to, you know, surprise them and just win the game.
The bot lane is mostly about Vanda. He's really aggressive and in my opinion he's carrying Selova through laning phase.
Their bot lane is not that good.
Morales was at the last pick, was pretty much the star player of the SHC, but right now I think he's not that good anymore.
It might be because of their support changes, like Will Failure and Casing play really different than Mixa, so it might have affected him a bit.
We know our mistakes, but it's pretty big problems right now. Our team play isn't where it needs to be, so we've got to get everything in check and everyone realizing what they have to do as part of the team. And if everyone's ready to perform and do their part, then I think we'll beat Roccat.
I think our season was really up and downs, and if we will have an up on the playoffs, I think it will be still okay.
One of the interesting things to hear from that one, especially when it comes to this 2v2 in middle, we already heard that Overpower plays it safe, which makes him naturally then harder to take down anyway.
So you can look at it two ways. You have the aggressive Selfie here who sometimes gets an early kill and then starts rolling and snowball the game, but it also completely backfires, so maybe Roccat is ready here. Wait for Selfie to be over-aggressive, punish him instantly, kill him, and shut him down.
Well, before the teams head into Champions League, make sure you head to Twitter and tell us which team do you think will win today and why. Remember to tweet at LOL Esports and use hashtag ROCWin or hashtag SHCWin with your answer.
And tell us the picks, the players, or strategies that you think will take this series and send one of these teams to the semifinals. I'm going to read your responses later in the show.
So let's, as we move to Champions League, nail it down a little bit more on the bans and the picks. And starting in the top lane, because for Maima, there's a very big trend this year.
Yeah, so Shyvana has been his go-to champion. 16 games, crazy like 7+ KDA, died 15 times. Really, really good performance on Shyvana. However, she's kind of fallen a bit out of favor. So I'm not sure if Super Correct wants to play here or if Roccat wants to ban it. Instead, however, I could see Roccat focus towards someone like Selfie. They've done it before where they ban pretty much everything he plays. And then maybe a fist ban against Opa because he's been his best champion.
Well, let's take a look. We're going to get into Champions League for our first game in this best of five quarterfinal matchup. Yeah, for the summer playoffs. And the first ban's coming out. One of them aimed towards Jankos. Lee Sin here. Interesting choice to take away. We've seen that Jankos, most of his first bloods have been coming his way, actually, over on Lee Sin. On Elise. However, Lee Sin is his most played champion, albeit just by a couple of games.
Yeah, still a few changes to Lee Sin here in 4.12. Slightly weakened team fights. His damage early game, however, is the same. Still being banned away. Focus on Subaru instantly towards Jankos. They talked about how he was the star player. And when Roccat win games, it's often Jankos who gets off to a good start, snowball some of the lanes, and then they do well as a team.
So, second ban coming out for the support crew, another interesting one, Kale. Research has been telling us that Roccat have been practicing this.
Yeah, it could both be played in top lane and mid lane. Overpower was known for Kale in the mid lane. And also tells me Subar crew maybe wants to play Yasuo, seeing as they ban away. If they do ban Zillion here, it definitely looks towards a Yasuo pick.
Well, you predicted it right. Zillion will be taken away. Other side, Mundo, TF, and then Maokai as the final ban here by Roccat. So a couple of top lane bans against Selfie. Funnily enough, he's most played champion, and you know, he's most played by a very, very long way. 16 games on Shyvana, his next played champion, most played champion is Mundo with 3 games. Yeah. That's a ridiculous difference.
So Roccat here clearly been doing their scouting. Look towards Maima, 2 of his tank picks up there, and ooh, Kassadin was left open.
Yeah, kind of missed that one. We did it last week as well when Kassadin somehow managed
You're so used to being banned.
It should automatically just think, okay, well, Kassadin must be in there somewhere. But Kassadin getting through this one. Question is, will Selfie run this one? We've also seen earlier today over in Korea that first pick Kassadin's coming in, then shifting him into the top lane later on so they can still counter-pick against the red side mid lane choice. We'll see how that goes here, though, for the Supa Hot Crew. Either way, Kassadin's Kassadin at the end of the day.
Did have a few nerfs lately, but he's still Kassadin, can still get completely out of control very fast. And Roccat, because knowing they will give the Kassadin away, instantly could have prepared the two next picks.
And that will be Kog'Maw. Not the safest of AD carries when people are jumping on top of you. Piled in there, though, with the Morgana, which we expected was going to be a hotly contested one, especially in this patch.
Yeah, so she's one of the few supports who didn't get any changes, where a lot of, like, Thresh and Braum got a bit weaker. Morgana stayed the same. Also been the best pick for Vander and Kassadin here, so no surprise Roccat early picks it. And Celebar as well. Roccat, they love to early pick the AD carry. Last week, in Super Week, 3 out of 4 games, they first picked the AD carry for Celebar. They trust 100% in him being able to play the laning phase properly, or maybe it's because his champion pool isn't very big, so they want to secure his a comfort pick for him as early as possible. Just open up for Subaru now to pick their bottom lane.
And they're going to take at least Nami for that. We'll see if this Tristana gets locked in. Actually, will, in fact, be locked in there as well. So definitely a bit of an interesting one. In fact, if we look back at last week's game between these two teams in Super Week, it was a Kog'Maw versus Tristana bottom lane, although and actually in this exact order with Roccat having the Kog'Maw. Funnily enough, Lucian coming completely through this time around, obviously being enabled for this week. Not going to be picked up by either of these two AD carries. What are Roccat now going to go for? Elise, with Lee Sin banned out, is the natural choice, I think, for Jankos.
Yeah, been actually, in my opinion, his best jungler. Better than Lee Sin, because Roccat, again, as a team, love to use this Elise to fast push towers early. And Alistar just got locked in. Morgana's already picked. We have seen Opa play Morgana mid lane once. It didn't work at all. And I did actually check Zazzle's and his solo queue games lately. There is Trinity 4, Static Shift, Frozen Heart, Alistar top lane. Which clearly seems to be legit.
Well, if you're going to pick it in a game of this magnitude, then Zazzle's obviously will be feeling confident enough for that.
I want to last pick it, though.
You also have to, last pick it. You also have to wonder as well, could this be mind games from Roccat? Because if you could find his games, so could the Supa Hot Crew and figure that one out. Whether we'll see any role switches, obviously we have to figure that one out as things go forward. And look at this, the Supa Hot Crew, what are they going to do now? Not trusting Kassadin because he's always one for hovering over whatever. Renekton is a possibility. Although, again, another champion that we've seen less and less as the weeks have gone on.
Yeah, I would actually like to see Mimer log in Shyvana, but I do believe he wants Renekton because they've casted in the mid lane, so they want a strong laner now up in the top side, so they don't have 2 weak solo laners early on, or somewhat weak solo laners. So they do pick in Renekton. Buys time now for both Tristana and Kassadin to scale because you have the early mid-game power from Mimer here. And then Kha'Zix for the jungle. I mean, we have seen Diamond play it where he evolves W. I've seen it in solo queue a few times as well. I wonder if Impaler's gonna do the same.
Well, it's a new pick. Certainly didn't play him in any of their 4 games last week in the jungle. Did actually head himself over to Jarvan in that last win against the Copenhagen Wolves. And Elise, who of course is banned away before that in 3 games just before. So then, let's see exactly how Roccat are gonna piece this puzzle together. We've got Alistar in there, we've got Morgana, so one of those we're expecting to drop into that support role, and that's exactly how you predicted. If this Orianna gets locked in, it goes Morgana in the support role and Alistar with Zazzus in the top lane.
And look at all the protection here from Roccat. Celebi in these team fights is gonna be so hard for Supa Hot Crew to kill. You have an Alistar to peel, you have Orianna, you have Morgana to peel. Even Elise can peel for her AD carry. So very, very protect our hyper carry comp here from Roccat. But this Alistar in the top lane, we can just look at it once we actually get into the game. Because I'm very curious how Zazzus will actually play it in the top lane. If he's gonna go Trinity 4 Static Shift and just try and focus on split pushing and then teleporting in behind the enemy and set up fights here. They can, of course, do the delivery system, Orianna ball onto Alistar, jump into the enemy team and you just try and blow someone up. Supa on the other side, you had the early power from Renekton, and then you need to stun and caster them to get past the weak mid-game point and into a late game. Otherwise, Roccat might be able to close the game in time.
Interesting to see as well how Impaler plays this Kha'Zix here. As you mentioned, he's not been playing Kha'Zix all that recently. Kha'Zix, for me, has been a champion that's been hit and miss when we've seen him in the past, although Diamond might disagree with me on some of that, but a lot of junglers have just stayed away from him.
So it's mainly because the playstyle for Kha'Zix is so different now compared to what it used to be. Now, if you do involve your W, you're all about poking and kiting teamfights. In that case, when you have an Alistar engaging, if you manage to kite and avoid like the shockwave engage, then Subaru can maybe disengage, because they have Kassadin to chase, and then Tristana to get the reset, and then they can really start jumping in and pick up kills.
Interesting as well. Zazus, as you mentioned, spotted him in solo queue, picking up.
I didn't expect him to actually play.
Yeah, I mean, you can look at his solo queue games all day long. To pull it out in the first game of the quarterfinal, where your spot at the World Championships are up for grabs, is definitely a ballsy move here from Zazus. We're going to find out how it works as we get in game for our first match of the best of five. It's a Supa Hot Crew taking on Roccat. And this is going to be a really interesting one. We said it before that unlike the normal weeks in the LCS, you have a full week to prepare for one best of five. And for me, that's where you are going to see the more maybe crazy strategies and picks. True. I mean, we've got an Alistar top lane here.
Yeah. And so Alistar top lane, in my head, shouldn't be very strong early game, especially not against the Renekton, if you do just in terms of laning one-on-one. He's of course very strong if he roams around, he has good sustain. But one-on-one against a Renekton, I'm not sure if he can actually deal or do anything against Mimer. But if he does go for the Trinity Force and the Static Shift, the trick is when you headbutt a target, you can actually auto-attack them in the air. And then you have the Trinity Force with procs, you have the Static Shift, and you have like this upfront burst before you activate your Q. And therefore you get like a head start in the small traits. And you can split push really well because you have a lot of wave clear. But still, must be like a team fight pick. Build around protecting Celavar. Of course, going to be very tanky in the late game.
And it's an interesting one as well. If you look at Roccat's games last week, if I run through the games that he's played with Kog'Maw against the Supa Hot Crew, the win 1-0-3, the next game 1-2-0, after that 2-4-5. Not exactly hyper carry kind of scorelines. We'll see if they can protect him here today and whether Celavar can come up with a good. Right now, though, it looks like Roccat may be going for the invade towards that blue buff. Could also be just to stick down those wards, although we're fairly late on into things. That blue buff going to be spawning in just a second or so. And it looks like Roccat are going to challenge and take that away.
Yeah, and Zazus here, rune-wise, AP, Quince, I believe it is, and also for Masteries, and then he started Flask, so he has 23 AP here, level 1. Let's see what he can do. They do actually lane swap, which does make a lot of sense, because now Zazus can roam around on Alistar and doesn't have to be in a lane against Renekton, where he shouldn't be able to do anything here. So, a little bit surprised Subaru didn't try to predict the lane swap, or maybe they were just happy saying, you know what, we can deal with this roaming Alistar.
And he's going to be sticking with Jankos in the jungle for now. And actually, Mimer recalling, if you look down the bottom lane there on the minimap as well, we're also seeing Orwersian recall. So we'll see if there's any switch up on that front. It may just be a case of Mimer going to head into the jungle and actually do exactly the same as Zazus over the other side and just shadow Impaler throughout things. Although that bottom lane is now starting to recall. And we'll see then how that one all works out. Impaler, of course, did steal away the blue buff, so it was a simple trade of blues. However, he didn't finish off the camp.
Yeah, so he left a small minion here. Roccat would expect him to have cleared it, so Subaru had a timer. Now, none of the teams actually have the timer on blue buff just yet, and which also means Overpower will get his blue buff delayed compared to self here, unless, of course, Roccat want to keep contesting for Subaru's blue buff. For now, though, they are waiting for someone from Supa Hot Crew to show themselves, moving towards this top lane here.
Well,
they're going Dragon.
Yeah, this is a very quick one as well. 3.5 minutes into it. Three men on that one. Tristana is alone down in that bottom lane, just going to be farming up on that front. So should actually be joining in here in just a second. And this should be the dragon going over. There is a ward there just on the top side of the river. Actually, we're seeing a very early teleport coming down to it. The Supa Hot Crew saying, no, we don't want to get involved with that, especially with an Alice who can get right into the middle, pulverize four of you. And that single TP, yes, it might cost Silas in the near future in terms of getting into lane or what have you, although he's down the bottom side of the map now anyway, but he stopped the early dragon attempt by the Supa Hot Crew.
A very good response here, and it's what we need to see when there's lane swaps and we have these very early dragons, because you take so much damage from it unless you really play it nice around the dragon here. It means the other team can send down two members, three members, and stop you, which just happened here. So teleport down for Zazus, but Mimer to use his up in the top lane anyway, and therefore we are going back to now, Mimer farming in the top lane, no dragon taken, and Yanka's helping the cow down here in this bottom lane.
That mid lane choice as well, the Kassadin obviously first picked in, so Selfie knew that he was going to be up against something which will probably cause him problems in that laning phase, which you could definitely say Orianna is. However, we've said it before, that Overpower has been a safer player. If there's someone that's maybe not going to punish you for having a Kassadin in the mid lane, that might just be Overpower.
Yeah, at the moment, Selfie's slightly behind, but he does have teleport, so he can go back, heal up, and rejoin the lane if Overpower will let him. But he is farming okay in this mid lane. Opa and Orianna should be looking to farm his own jungle camps as soon as possible. But look here, Alistar top lane roaming around.
Yankos gonna join him as well. Can Roccat pick up another first blood? Actually, Selfie gonna be low on mana here. There is the flash into the head, but didn't quite connect for Zylus. A flash away from Selfie will keep him safe for now, but for how long without a flash in that mid lane? Only level 5 for now. So, I mean, once that Rift Walk comes in, obviously, he'll be feeling a lot more confident. But for now, dangerous times for him in that mid. And we saw him there actually trying to recall. Roccat stopping him, and now he's going to be in two minds. Does he stay and try and defend this turret, or does he back off with his life intact? Impaler had come across, so they'll be able to hold on for that for now. In fact, Kasing was there as well.
And this is what Roccat loves to do, especially when they have a lease. Is these early rotations between the lanes where they get some damage on the tower. Don't have to kill it. Just get some damage, move on to top lane, move down to bottom lane. Do the same thing. You fast push them out here. You roam around with multiple members. And it's one of the reasons I really like Yankos on Elise, because he's so active in the lanes. Yes, he gives up some farm, but if he gets lane XP anyway, it doesn't really matter.
Now, since this has returned down to bottom, funnily enough, all that roaming that he's done, 7 to 5 CS, he's up. We actually saw Mimer spending his entire time really up on that top side of the map. Does have a couple of levels advantage over him just because he was sat in lane that entire time. Also, both top laners using TP roughly the same time as well. Mimer's will be slightly ahead of him.
But also keep in mind how much help Yankos has been giving Zazus here so he could farm, while Supa Hot Crew has completely left Mimer alone. Kasing stayed in the bot lane, even though he didn't actually do a lot after Zazus roamed away. And Impaler, just been farming as well, not been helping Mimer up in his top lane. So he has been denied a lot of CS. Now he's one-on-one against Celebor. We can already see him pick up a few CS.
That's the interesting thing from Roccat's side as well, that Yankos did spend so much time there, but he's pretty much level on CS. And on levels themselves, has got as much XP. So
all the lane experience.
Yeah, all that lane experience coming through, helping him out on that front. And actually, we've got a bit of invasion play going on both sides of the map, actually. Yankos and Vander coming across towards that blue buff. Same going on down the bottom side. But let's not forget, the blue buff on Roccat's side of the map will be spawning in later because the camp wasn't taken away on the initial invade.
But look how Supa Hot Crew already set up for when the blue buff will spawn. Pick wards, a lot of wards in general in the jungle of Roccat here to make sure the bottom side of the map is in their control. And Roccat has just been doing the same thing up here. Now they didn't actually clear the blue buff, so we'll be delayed for Selfie possibly later. And once again, Yankos, fast moving between the lanes, always gonna join in with the wave, get some damage on the tower. Now to take it down, we can go towards the bottom lane, do the same deal, and go into mid lane where Kassadin doesn't have enough wave clear to respond if two or three members from Roccat suddenly shows up and the rest of Supa Hot Crew isn't ready. So they're just doing this fast movements between the lanes, always with Yankos.
Now we see Overpower once again guiding a nice wave of minions in there, and Selfie not really got much to say about it. Actually takes the damage despite that Rift Walk coming out. Overpower playing this lane fairly aggressively here, and actually they've got the rest of the team starting to move up there as well. Impaler and Kasing have come around. Zazus will join in, and there's actually a TP from Mimer really putting a big priority, sorry, from Selfie, I forgot that he had TP as well, putting a big priority on making sure that this middle tower doesn't go down for free as well.
All right, so forced away the TP can now send Silver down to this bottom lane and start doing the same deal, push out the waves here. And Roccat, again, we keep talking about how they love to move around the lanes here. But the cool thing for Roccat is it's actually very low risk, high reward, because you are three members up in the top lane. You know there's only maximum two, the top lane and jungler, from Super Hawk Crew, because you saw Kassing on the map. Therefore, it's not really in danger when you send Yanker's top to push down the tower. It's not like he's suddenly going to get collapsed on. And it's just the Roccat playstyle. Low risk, high reward, otherwise they don't do it. Because we have seen them many times give up objectives because they didn't feel like they were in a position to fight.
And that's the thing that we've always said is the thing to work on from Roccat's side, that when you've got a lead going into the mid and the start of the late game, that they sometimes struggle to really close it out. There we actually see the smite from Yankos just to make sure that blue buff wasn't stolen away. So Overpower not going to get his hands on one this time around.
All right, but Selfie lost his blue buff as well, so true. Both mid laners. Can just continue standard laning and still very even in form. It is actually harder and harder to shut down a Kassadin, especially because of the magic shield. But it's all about the tower now for Roccat. They want to push down the lane, send in one or two members, get the tower down, and then they can focus on the bottom lane and then start getting some deep wards in the jungle of Super Hawk Crew. But again, we talk about how Kassadin and Tristana, not the best champions in the mid game. They want to kind of get past it and get to a late game where they can really carry games.
And speaking in this bottom lane now, we heard a little bit in the video that both teams didn't seem to have too much faith in one another's bottom lane, saying it's possibly the weak point that Mr. Oz in spring was a beast and he's been somewhat quiet. So we're going to see Impaler coming in. Zazus now is level 7, so he pops his ultimate and we've seen the changes to the cow. He doesn't take any damage.
Doesn't take any damage here. We did see Impaler evolve his W and now we did see the push in the mid lane from Roccat as we talked about earlier. Two towers down, all about the bottom lane. Already pushed down, they're just waiting for Yankos to make a move. There's teleport on Zazus in case they need him to join in as well. And full focus on towers for Roccat here early.
Although it's Zazus not getting first blood, he's been there all of a sudden when they wanted to push these two towers down. And always been working out for them up until now. Zazus actually going to go in here, spot Maimu, has to pop his ultimate actually. Let's see how this one goes. Pulverize goes down. Maimu going to dive in on top of him. Has he actually got the damage to kill off Zazus now that he's got no ultimate? He doesn't, and that will be Zazus simply walking away. Sheen actually was picked up as that first item for Zazus. Maimu only been back the once and picked up a blade.
And Roccat, in terms of farm, really won out on the lane swap. If you look at Celavar, he's ahead compared to Mr. Rylus. And also the cow in the top lane managed to actually get a lot of farm in the lane swap. So now they've swapped back. Yes, Mimer has been doing a good job now, catching up as expected on a Renekton. But still, just the fact they actually do have 45 CS on Zazus is a good thing for Roccat. And Lichpin first item, so I do expect him to build a Trinity Force. I wonder then if it's going to go Static Shift as second item.
Well, let's figure out. We're going to see here the start possibly of the dragon. The pink ward going down. Vision from the backside going to be cleared out here. And Roccat going to start that one off nicely. Can they actually finish it? There are a couple of men hanging around on the backside for the Super Hawk Crew, but nowhere near quick enough to get in to stop it. And there is the first dragon of the game, of this full best of five series even, going over to Roccat.
Yeah, so Roccat, remember, didn't even lose the dragon, even though they were the team to lane swap up to the top side. Managed to stop Super Hawk Crew from the dragon. Maimer was just no ultimate, he was down to 50% HP, he couldn't really join in for a fight. Zazus had already been back to the base, and also Super Hawk Crew was just not in a position actually, an easy dragon here for Roccat.
Celebrate just going to be sitting back, 110 CS for him. He's been averaging, if you look at the 10 minute mark, the around about 81 CS at the 10 minute mark, so doing really well. This game around has a 10 CS lead over his opponent, Mr. Rawls. Mid lane, you have to give credit to Selfie. He's got past that point where Orianna could have really bullied him away, and he's managed to keep that one, for all intents and purposes, level now.
Lost the tower.
True.
But kept even in farm here, so Roccat not putting a lot of effort into trying to stop Selfie from farming. We only saw one gank early on where he got some damage on the tower, and then actually left Selfie alone. She just didn't farm. Which means Super Hawk Crew, if they do manage to buy enough time, will get the items they need. We got early T already, stacking up here. Rod of Ages, gonna be a bit delayed for him. But for now, he's just looking to pick up all the farm he can. And I have to see if Roccat actually wants to be very aggressive. He wants to take down the last tower. Because the wave clear on the side of Super Hot Crew. You have Tristana, but there's no early static shift, which means if Roccat does group early on, there's actually not a lot of wave clear on the side of Super Hot Crew.
And the interesting thing as well from the Super Hot Crew side, if you think back to last week, their first couple of games, we talked about the fact that, especially the Rengar game against Roccat, I believe it was, the Impaler didn't really do a lot. He didn't really show up on the map. We've come to expect that the Super Hot Crew have kind of changed their focus away from bottom lane ganks to middle and top, but Impaler's not really been anywhere on the map up until now. And he's behind in farm.
Behind in farm, had one gank in the top lane, forced an ulti, and then he actually just went back to the jungle, and we haven't seen him. Not been in the lane to try and to defend the towers whenever Jankos was moving around here. So it's just been way too easy for Roccat here in the early game to take control of all the lanes, take control of the towers, and get this goal lead they have. Because the next dragon spawning, they have the timer, they can be ready, ward up, and again, just wait for Subaku to make a move. If they do move in for a fight, Roccat, because they have the goal lead, should be in a good position to take it. So, not a good start by Subaku. Let's see what Jankos wants to do.
Well, there are wards down, yeah. Wards on both sides there, one in the tribush, one on the sidebush watching. Impaler is hanging around here though now, so we could see first blood possibly coming out as we see Black Shield.
Oh, he's
just
going to
block out everything. Actually, Mimer coming down. Selfie's going to be there as well. Counter TP from Zaza's coming around. And Roccat are going to try and turn this one around. They managed to catch him. Selfie, there's the knockup. And the first blood for the top lane cow.
Top lane cow. Mobility boost. Teleport down. It was four members from Roccat against five from Super Crew. As soon as they saw the teleport, everyone just ran away. And Selfie was caught. He died. He had flash and everything. Now second or third tower story for Roccat. Things are looking good, and Super Hot Crew, they need to wake up.
They need to wake up really quickly here as well, because Roccat have got four minions coming in with them. They've got four players. They could have a good go at this turret. Only Impaler is there right now to actually stop the Roccat damage coming into this one. There is finally the teleport from Mimer, sorry, from Selfie coming down. Mimer uses in that last fight. Damn it, double TPs coming in. But Roccat, either way, good push. One thing that impressed me there, Mr. Rawls, and there's the vote, actually, 62%. Over for the Super Hot Crew. Something tells me that might be changing here in the next moment. There's the flash in and he misses it. Kasing just sidesteps it and says, well, I think I can count myself lucky. Want to go back to my point about that bottom lane. Well, it wasn't really much of a fight. The first blood and the turret going down. Mr. Rawls was sat on the BF sword compared to the Trinity Force. They actually hit him with the Kog'Maw ulti just before he was going to go back. And kept him there, so they had a massive advantage when it came to the damage coming out the AD carries as well.
Very, very true, but we're still five members from Super Hot Crew.
True, five versus four either way.
And as a caster with Flash, you should never be caught out. Like, never. The rest of the team backed away, Selfie stayed a bit too long, he got caught out. Believe it was a good binding from Vander. He flashed in, and then of course Zasus joined in as well and killed him and the tower here. And now with these Trinity Forces, should be completed on Alistar very soon as well. We always talk about how Trinity Force is like the first power spike you get here in the mid game. So at this point, Celebar is a lot stronger than Mr. Alice. And therefore, Roccat once again can look to make plays.
Selfie trying to do some damage to Overpower.
Mid lane too. I mean, Selfie, he needs to stack up now. He needs time. Where Overpower can already team fight. Yes, okay. You want your death cap. Sorry to interrupt you, by the way. You want your death cap on Orianna. But still, he has more damage than Selfie, and Roccat can look for these teamfights now.
Just clearing out a ward. Vander getting a little bit close there. Did have Selvar as a bit of backup, and they know now that pink ward is there for the taking a little bit later on. Super Hot Crew actually coming back towards that bottom lane with their duo. No tower behind them, so need to be very careful about that. And we see that Jankos has actually been spotted. I think he may have just been trying to clear a ward out. It was, in fact, gets one down of his own. That's because his dragon's coming up next. So all four men there down the bottom for Roccat. Zazus doesn't have teleport though. And Mimer, where is Mimer? Mimer's already there.
He's there. Zazus shouldn't be sitting in the top lane here. They got the first dragon, they had the timer. He should have been down with the team. He's running down from this top lane, but he's gonna be joining very, very late.
Coming down to it, but can they hold him away? We see the ultimate used out of Kasing. That might be a big factor when it comes to fighting here for the Super Hot Crew. And there is Zazus, just going to knock Selfie away. Has to run. He's got his ulti available. Will give him lots of protection as a shockwave comes in. They're actually going to try and go for Mima here. Zazus up at the front will headbutt him away from the rest of the team. That might be enough damage onto Mima for the Roccat to be able to wedge themselves in and take Dragon.
And we did again, just see the idea behind Alistar top lane. When you have your Sheen and you headbutt him and you hit him in the air, you get the headbutt damage and the Sheen proc. So actually some very good damage onto Selfie as the very first engage. Of course, the late game, you don't really have a lot of damage. You just become this super tank you can peel. But onto the Dragon, Impaler down his bottom lane, going in.
Trying to get in, but it's going to be Roccat to get it. And now Impaler stuck inside of the Dragon Pit will go down. That's a one kill once again for the count. Mima is going to fall. And now the rest pile in. Mr. Alt has joined, though. And that's going to be a kill back for them. Vander is low, too. But they do kill off Tristana. Selfie will have to try and escape or maybe try and mop up Vander. They're chasing Kasing, but he's managed to speed himself up. And now they turn around. They're going to have a go at Selfie. He's going to run into no man's land. Roccat may chase or may just let him go. Hard to track down the Kassadin.
Teleporting. Okay, again, force teleport. You get the timer, minions on him. Subaru could have gone for the steal, but should never have gone for the full team fight. They are behind in goal. They're weak at this point as well. Just if you look at the comps. They jump in, misses the smite from Impaler, Dragon for Roccat, and now the team fight. It's so easy for them to win. Mima goes down very, very fast. Mr. Rylus even jumps in to try and get a reset. Gets one kill, but that's about it. Damage is gone now. Selfie's not able to join in for the fight again. Kasing managed to escape, but Roccat winning the fight, get the dragon. Look at the gold.
And Kasing actually flashing over the bind in there as well. If that would have landed, that would have been four kills coming down for Roccat. They lead this game 4-1 in kills, 31 to 26,000 gold at this point, 20 minutes into the match. Let's have a look down some items now. You were talking about Orianna's death cap. That is now done. We see the makings of the blade for Selva as well. Top lane, looks like Static Shift's coming next for the cow.
Okay, so split pushing cow, who then just teleports in behind you. You get his horn in the ass, and it hurts. And then you have a shockwave mobile power, and you die if you are out of position here. So it is actually pretty legit. 2-0-2, top lane Alistar, quarterfinals. ULCS.
It's very interesting to see whether it's warranted a ban so far. Obviously, we'll see that when we come to game number two. If you're just joining us, of course, this is just the first game of our best of five quarterfinal. The winner of Roccat and the Super Hot Crew will go on to face Fnatic at Gamescom for a place at Worlds, essentially. Yeah. You win that semi final and you're on your way to Asia for the World Championships.
I mean, Mimer said it so well in the pregame. If you lose, suddenly we fight for relegation, or to avoid relegation. If we win, we fight for Worlds. Massive difference here for the teams. The quarterfinals are so, so important. Because again, remember, the two losers face each other. Fighting for number five in the standings. If you lose that game, that's relegation.
Selfie there. Pretty lucky in my eyes. Hit the Rift Wall just as he saw the cocoon coming out. Did hit him, but he already made the jump over the wall. If that would have hit him just a split second quicker, that could well have been a dead Kassadin. If we look down the side of the Super Hot Crew, that single kill that they have with the support right now, Kasing could really do with picking up a couple of those, a couple more kills just to give them some boost in items because they are falling dangerously far behind at this stage. And that is the tower going down as well. And if you look at a team that's got the likes of a Cogmore, you have to pin back for as long as you can. This is dangerous territory to be in, falling behind so early on.
Yeah, good job by Roccat using the siege they have with Orianna. Selva as well with his long range. You have a black shield to avoid pretty much any engage possible. And of course, Elise, jungle once again. Jenga's been part of every single tower.
Funny as well, because
why do you ban Lee Sin?
Yeah, ban Lee Sin, his most played champion. Totally understand that one, but Elise has been the one that he's really come out strong with. And yes, she's had her changes. You know, cocoon's harder to, or maybe you could even say easier to hit. Depends how many minions and how you have to thread that needle through them. So far though, Jankos been in form for his team. Not got a first blood, but I'm not sure that Roccat really care about that when they're approaching a 10,000 gold lead. Super Hot Crew actually pushing towards mid. Not going to get anything there, though.
Now, while it's looking very good for Roccat, we have seen in the past they tend to slow down a little bit. Take it very, very safe. No risks. And it buys time for the other team to get the form they need to get into a late game point. Just think back to Roccat vs. Alliance, where Roccat was so far ahead at like a zillion mid lane. Corgi AD carry, full mid game comp. 12,000 gold ahead. Didn't manage to finish it. Alliance came back, won the game. Supa Hawk crew will be looking to do the same here. You need to static shift now on Mr. Alice so you can sit and wave clear and just form as much as you can and not get caught out in your jungle.
Cocoon lands on 2-0, they got the damage. There is a Rift Walk into a flash from Selfie. So close to going down. Having to use that summoner spell, and look at Roccat. They're moving straight towards this bottom lane. The cat will be able to clear out the wave quick enough, and that is a four-man push. Mr. Alls and Kasing, the only two to try and defend it. It is going to go down. Supark could get one in return, but it's the outer turret in the top lane.
Let's see, Supark crew actually managed to trade one for one and just hold Roccat where they are. And actually, everyone's going to recall, so Roccat now going to go back, spend some gold. Static shift just picked up for Zasus on Alistar. If you told me the day before we would see this from a top lane Alistar, wouldn't have believed you. But it's working for now. Let's see if he can actually dual Mimer. Nope.
Well, the spotlight was on Zasus there and not quite what he was looking for.
Come on, smack him.
And, well, that static shift now coming in, you can see a lot of movement speed
did
for the cow.
Did
manage to knock him away with a head. But. As you said, no auto attack to follow up for damage. It needs to be a bit careful here. Three men from the Supa Hawk crew starting to move around. Selfie actually will be forced away. And look at this again. Roccat making a fantastic decision. They see that there are people up top. They go straight in for the dragon. Mimer even lost half of his HP there to Zasus.
So as soon as we looked at a dragon, Zasus went on Mimer. Oh, he might be in trouble.
He might, but he saved that pulverize here. He's going to use his ultimate. Will that be enough damage reduction to get him away? Selfie now moving in as well. Zasus slowed. Flash comes in. Here comes Vander from the side as well. He's the only man there, though. But two versus three, they've managed to force the Supa Hawk crew to disengage.
70% damage reduction is so strong here. Alistar didn't go down. No tank items yet. Didn't even matter. Onto this tower again. Headbutt, auto attack, and you have this burst from static chip and a sheen. The whole idea behind this Alistar build. I do expect him to go tank now and just keep these two damage items as everything he needs.
Well, maybe he'll surprise us and go for something different.
A hurricane. Smack everyone.
Hurricane out, so yeah. Not quite going to work out for him. But we see the health coming in, so it looks like we will be seeing some more tankiness. If we look over on the other side, a lot of half-completed stuff, really, for the Supa Hawk crew this far behind. Tiamat start for Mimer after having a tough 1v2 at the start. Never really putting down the power of the Renekton and having that early to mid-game bullying session that you'd expect from him. And on that same token, then, you have to just say, why not Shyvana at the end?
Yeah, we're definitely being better now and heading into a late game. The lane swap from Roccat. It's again why I was a little bit surprised at level 1. Yes, okay. Invading in on Morgana, Elise, and Alistar is probably not the smartest idea because the level 1 potential from Roccat, if you manage to lock down the target, is so, so strong. But the fact that Supa Hawk crew, or the fact that Roccat managed to get the lane swap, meant the Alistar pick suddenly could work, and also made Mimer very, very, I would almost say, useless on Renekton at this point. Because he didn't get his planning phase. Early game is gone. He now looks towards the late game also.
We've seen time and time again that he can't fight the count. They do both have teleport available though, and we've seen Roccat already starting to sweep Baron. Really like the ward placement up there as well. They have a pink ward outside of the Baron pit, and they have a pink ward inside of the Baron pit, just to make sure that any sneaky wards that could have been placed around those corners where Vander is standing will be spotted out. They have full vision control. There's a cocoon jumped away from by Impaler.
And this bottom lane, Selfie, once again. Ulti for Zasus, he backs away, and now Baron. There's the teleport, however, on both members from Supa Hawk crew.
Double TP available. Roccat actually did
here.
Start it off. We're going to have someone coming in, actually cancelled there. That was Mimer that cancelled his TP on the top side, so they still have Selfie to come down into that one. Zasus has his teleport available as well, so we'll see here if Roccat can't kind of dare go in this one. We've said it time and time again. Feels like broken record kind of thing over the course of this split where Roccat have had control of games and been so scared, really, of closing things out. There's Mimo once again being knocked up, taking a few turret hits. They're trying to bait him in because Selfie's come around the side as well. Zazzus loses half of his health, and he's able to just hang on, really. And now Overpower coming in, can't really do too much against that mobile Kassadin and Renekton.
We did see, however, once there's no ulti on the Zazzus, he's very squishy. One combo here from Selfie, he was down to 60% HP. Says what Super Crew can try and do, first gank, and then once ulti is gone, try again with the double teleport they have, which is very, very strong in the late game. Overpower won't be able to help. He needs to be with the team around Baron if they're baiting it, because otherwise he has to run the entire way from the bottom lane to Baron. It won't work here. So Super Crew with the double teleport definitely has the tools to try and stop Zazzus in this split push.
Roccat actually lost vision control of Baron as well while they were at it. And they're going to try and remedy that now, getting another pink ward inside of the pit itself and clearing that one out there just around the corner. 1 minute 50 until another dragon comes up, which Roccat have been very insistent on piling up the kills onto that one. See some other items coming in as well on the side of Roccat. Blade of the Rune King for Celever, I believe, has done a little while ago. That Zhonya's Hourglass now added in for Overpower. So three items, he's going to do a lot of damage whilst being safe as well.
Roccat's still staying around his Baron here. Nobody using the teleports. Just trying to bait Super Crew to actually face check them and get the fight they need, but every time they get managed to place a ward, they buy some time for Super Crew to just wait. Oh, Selfie!
And he calls out for this one. There's the follow-up of the CC. Have they got the damage? Jankos goes over, gives Selva the vision, and they catch out Selfie.
He didn't even have a ward.
It's been a story of the Super Crew so many times throughout this split, and now Roccat just turned straight on towards Baron. Super Crew are actually pushing up the mid lane here. Gonna possibly take an inner turret whilst losing a Baron. Impaler's still hanging around there. He's gonna have to be the man that steals this one away. He's already used one charge of his ultimate, goes off to the backside. You see Roccat just trying to body block this one of the Void Spike to go through. Impaler trying to get around. Oh. He's gonna get hooked. They dive out the back. Baron gets picked up. However, the Super Hot Crew have taken that inner turret. They're now working on the inner turret as Gesink flashes away as well.
So Super Hot Crew here, while they lose the Baron because Selfie, I have no idea what he was doing. Walks in by himself, face checks them, and oh, Super Crew, you did.
Yeah, well, at least one of them is. Mimer's going to try to escape from this one. Let's see if they can get away from the next combo of Zazzus. It's a flash that's used. Oh, nice sidestep of the finding. There's the ultimate coming out from Banda. Zazzus is on top of him as well. They can chain that CC through, and they get the two kills. Yes, they've lost that in-him turret, but it actually puts them now almost just a smidgen of gold away from 10,000 gold lead.
So the Baron Dance here paid off for Roccat again. Selfie, no ward, just walks in to check. Four members of Roccat dies, once again, has flash, doesn't use it on the binding, gets hit by the binding, and then he just gets chain CC'd by Roccat. When you have released Morgana, we always talk about how land the first cocoon or binding and then follow with the next one. People are just locked down for like 5 seconds. It's so hard to deal with. Unless you have flash, and you can flash the first one and avoid the second one.
Have a look here on this inventory, which Super Hot Crew, against all odds, managed to take Roccat out with that last Baron takedown. Celebrate a little bit low there, so definitely want to be careful of it with the danger of Kassadin diving onto you. Mimer maybe being able to get in there, and Kha'Zix, of course. So they back away, going to steal away a little bit of jungle, get some buffs, take themselves another dragon on the way out. I'm guessing that there's a lot of gold to spend here. Yes,
oh, yeah.
Everyone has a hell of a lot of gold. That's only going to be more here as another dragon goes down. You can see 3K on the AD carry, 2,000 on the mid laner, jungler, and top laner, and the support is not far away from that. That's another spike here in power that's going to happen for Roccat with the Baron buff still running as well.
And Mr. Rallis actually went for Phantom Dancer here on Tristana, not a static shift to provide some more wave clear. So full focus for him on towards like late game teamfights where Phantom Dancer will give you more damage than a static shift, but less wave clear. So really tells him his Super Crew just want to try and play the side lanes like we have seen before here with double teleport, and hope Roccat is going to send members to try and stop the push in the side lanes and therefore not push down as a group. But we do have an Alistar, we just picked up a Frozen Heart. That's a lot of armor. And his ulti, 70% damage reduction. You can dive on the Super Hot Crew. If Cocoon or Binding lands, expect Roccat to just go straight for the dive and kill whatever member they lock down.
with that last purchase, actually, just to run quickly down the list as they start this siege up once again, it was the Banshees for Jankos. These bubbles come out here. That turret's going to go down. Banshees for Jankos. Last Whisper for Celeva. Frozen Heart for Zazas. Void Staff for Overpow. That's some big items coming out. And Roccat here are going to be able to take the inhibitor down. And I'm assuming just going to move simply around to that bottom lane. Top lane still actually has an inner turret left standing. The waves are pushed up on both lanes to the midpoint of it, up to the river. So that gives the Supa Hot Crew a little bit of time here to regroup.
Supa Crew, they need to just try and fight, to be honest. They don't have the wave clear to stop Roccat from taking down the towers, especially not with the Baron buff. So they have to just try and put Selfie on the side so he can like flank around Roccat and then just have everyone else pile on someone like Celeva. Try and kill him instantly. You're not going to kill Alistar. Orianna has an hourglass. She's not going to die either. It's all about trying to kill Celeva here. But then you need Selfie in a position where he can actually jump in from the side or behind him. And at the moment, he's standing in the base. But let's see if Roccat want to go for dive or just look to hit the tower every time they have the chance. The wave is not going to die very far.
Well, Celeva already chipping away on that tower to bring it down to about half HP. Zazas up at the front with his Frozen Heart. Gonna take Mr. Rawls, or gonna cause him problems, certainly. Need to be very careful about how close he actually gets and how close the cow gets. There is the cocoon landing. Binding actually will follow up. Will they go in for it? Zazas actually does dive in. You see the damage there out of the top lane. Cow as a tidal wave is used. Bubble will land, but there's no follow up here from the Supa Hot Crew. Worth noting though, Roccat's Baron buff is now gone. Well, look how low that tower is.
There's one more wave here. Mid lane is. Oh, Shockwave and Mimer. Managed to escape,
not
and
really
they go!
Mr. Rawls going to get caught out though! He's finished off, his Zazas against that to go on a rampage. They've got super minions hammering away now on the Nexus turrets as well. This could very well be game for Roccat. They're going to be finishing off that second in here. Nexus turrets are absolutely melted through. Supa Hot Crew with four men left up to try and defend. Not going to pull it off, but Roccat pick up game number one. Move one step closer to the semi-final.
So remember, Maokai and Dr. Mundo was banned against Mimer in the top lane. He ended up picking Renekton, which did nothing because Roccat got the lane swap early here. Supa Hot Crew were afraid to invade in level one, play some deep wards because you were against Alistar, Elise, Morgana, all the CC. They couldn't invade. Even Orianna with the ball is so annoying to deal with it at level one, which meant we got the lane swap for Roccat. They got Alistar away from the Renekton. All of a sudden, Mimer ended up doing nothing. And Zazas, on this Alistar, did everything.
And was that then the reason for that Mundo pick that we were thinking? Now, we can look through these statistics and see Mundo is the second highest played champion of Mimer with 3 compared to Shyvana with 16. That Mundo going to be strong, especially someone that loves to play Mundo like yeah. Mimer, as we've seen it time and time again, against this double AP comp. Worked out really nicely either way. Something tells me the cow might not be getting it through into game number
no.
2.
Especially not because Supa Hot Crew clearly had no idea how to play against it. We kept seeing them like go for the first gank onto him, he popped the ulti, and then they just left him.
Yeah.
Instead of ganking him again when the ulti is gone, you have double teleport. It's where you have to kill him if you want to actually try and punish him in a lane swap. Kind of just imagine Kayle in a split push, pop the ult, and then next time you can try and kill him.
Mm.
But this Trinity 4 static shift on Alistar, headbutt and then your auto attack for Sheen proc and the static shift proc. We saw the damage, it was actually pretty good.
Late game, Mimer, he did it onto Mimer once yeah. he lost half of his health.
Exactly,
bar, so.
It actually worked really well. And then you just build full tank after, and you're not going to die because you have 70% damage reduction in these fights. And then you have a hyper carry, you have Morgana to protect, you even have Orianna skills well until late game. Just all around a good comp here by Roccat. But way too easy for them early game. Supa Hot Crew had no answer. Jankos just walked around the lanes, killed one tower, next tower, next tower, dragon. Okay, we're 5,000 gold ahead.
I'm going to play like the devil's advocate here and say that Supa Hot Crew didn't even try to answer them. Impaler in particular on Kha'Zix. We didn't really see him at all in this game.
Nope.
He went to top lane, I think, once. Other than that, he was in position to counter gank at the bottom lane. Funnily enough, at the point where they gave up first blood and then the tower straight away afterwards. Didn't have an impact at all in his first game.
So honestly, I actually believe Supa Hot Crew were very surprised by Kassadin being left open by Roccat. And when we have seen Selfie play Kassadin in the past, he's not been very good. I mean, Kassadin is Kassadin, but he's not been performing well. And as a team, they normally haven't been looking good on Kassadin here. And the fact that Roccat left it open Suddenly, Supa crew felt they had to first pick it. So whatever plan they had
is broken.
Could be completely broken by saying, oh, we have to take this first pick, Cassidy. And all of a sudden, nothing worked for them. It seemed like every single pick they actually locked in was just like, okay, we have this Cassidy. Try and build whatever we can around it and hope it works.
Well, a game one victory there for Roccat. We're going to send it over to Shox, though, for a breakdown of that win.
Thank you very much, Joe. I'm Efe Shog supporter, joined here by Trevor Quickshot Henry, and we have a special guest analyst here as well, Niff from Alliance. Thank you very much for joining us.
Hello.
Well, I'm actually going to start by asking you what I heard the Fisher say there, and of course, the Kassadin being left open. Do you guys feel that Supa Hot Crew tunneled on it too much and that Roccat had a perfect plan for it?
Maybe, yes. He's still really strong, and I think if they would have get a snowball or like one kill or something in the early game, they could have snowballed. But the game was really passing. I think the team was just too afraid to do anything, so it didn't work out for them.
Yeah, I also really liked seeing Alistar being pulled out from Roccat. It's something that we'd heard teams are trying in scrims and were playing. Interesting to see the Trinity force into static shiv build, really focusing on controlling the waves and taking advantage of that ultimate. Is it something that you've seen in scrims leading up to the playoffs? And what's your opinion on the Alistar top?
We have seen it once in the scrims, and it didn't work out there, so maybe they just needed a bit more time and practice it. I think the build is pretty good, actually. It gives him a lot of damage. The ulti gives him enough tank stats, and then later on you get the cooldown reduction, so you can have a lot of CC for the AD carries.
Let's actually take a look at the early game. So we saw the Kassadin pick coming out, and then actually what people, fans that are Supa Hot Crew, are afraid of is that Selfie won't be totally up to par when he comes into that game. And honestly, he did get caught out a couple of times. Do you think that set the tone for the rest of the game?
Yeah, you could see that they're too nervous and they just need to break the ice and play how they usually play. And if they get to that point, then they can win the game. But if they keep doing this and keep asking why they lose, then they will not come back.
Yeah, I also feel like this particular matchup, Roccat dictated the pace. You know, if you go look at the early stages, Niff pointed out upstairs that Roccat had weak laners. You know, Renekton was going to be able to bully Alistar in that situation, and Tristana and Nami could theoretically have bullied around the Kog'Maw. But Roccat started the lane swap and pulled the lane swap off very effectively. It went in their favor. Do you want to expand about what Roccat did fairly well in that lane swap, or why you thought it was quite strong?
First of all, it was really good since they had like, the losing top lane probably against Renekton, and the bot lane was slightly in favor for Supa Hot Crew as well. So they had this lane swap, and then they also could stop the dragon with the teleport from Alistar down. So that was really good for them, and then they could just farm equal, and then they got later on the kill as well with the teleport.
Yeah, let's actually take a look at one of those dragon fights. Let's get that up on the screen, because it was already going in Roccat's favor, and then the strategy, as you said, worked out perfectly.
Yeah, let's actually roll this clip out, and if we were quite surprised at some decisions. What's your take on this fight?
Okay, Pela jumps in, tries to steal, doesn't get it. Then he's in a really bad position. The team tries to collapse on them, but they can't really help him and he dies. And then Mr. Rollis, he jumps in for no reason. He should just stay away and out-attack as much as he could. He probably could have get Kog'Maw, but he jumps in and then he is in a really bad position. And then afterwards, Roccat has just to clean up because all of them were in a really horrible position. Kassadin can't do damage and Renekton didn't really do too much as well since he just died after Kha'Zix died.
I really feel like this team fight summarizes the game very well. Roccat started the dragon, pulled Supa Hot Crew towards him. Supa Hot Crew scrappily engaged, and Roccat punished them for mistakes.
Well, looking forward to game two. Let's break it down and see what both teams have to do. Maybe the Supa Hot Crew, first of all. Is there something in picks and bans that they should drastically change?
Not necessarily. Maybe you want to ban the Alistar because you're not so comfortable against it. But that's pretty much it. I think it's more has to do with the mindset that they're on the right track. And if they do that, then they can win the game.
Yeah, I actually agree. Making positive plays as opposed to reacting to your opponents, that can help Supa Hot Crew in this next game.
Yeah, and on the other side, Roccat, I mean, the thing that they might have been struggling with in the past, maybe the late game closing it out, nothing to see of that here. Very self-conscious.
Yeah, I actually think Roccat looked very good in this first game. I felt that Supa Hot Crew were going to be the stronger of the teams coming into the series. And Deficio did have a good point that Selfie and Kassadin has had struggles in the past, but he has had wins as well. And Roccat as a team, they've had counters to Kassadin, which have mixed results. I mean, they lost to Alliance's Kassadin. So Roccat seem to be confident, and we'll see if that confidence can carry through the rest of the series.
Yeah, we will see. And at the start of the show, we asked you guys to be the analysts yourselves and tell us which team do you think will win today and why. And here's what you had to say. The first one is from @Zeroknoth, #RockWin. They adapt faster to new patches and new OP champs and have a far better grasp of the jungle. Well, Alistar, well, can't even pronounce it anymore. Great pick to start out with.
Yeah, just could agree with that. I think Roccat is really always up in the meta and knows what's really strong. And you could see in the Bunsen picks as well, they took out Maokai because they really know that's a really strong pick right now. And then they picked like Alistar, which you might think it might be a support pick, but then it's top Alistar. And it's really surprising for a lot of teams. It works out.
The second one is from @MelodyMeows, hashtag SHG win, because even if both teams are inconsistent, SHG have the higher skill ceiling. If Selfie doesn't panic, he will carry.
I absolutely love this tweet, and I completely agree with it. Had a discussion with some of the other guys upstairs and said that, in my mind, Superhot Crew have a similar skill ceiling to the likes of Fnatic or Alliance, SK Gaming, but their skill floor is much lower. They don't hit the same consistent, strong, basic level, and it just demonstrated itself in this first game.
Yeah, and the last one is from @Solbert, lol. Superhot Crew will win because they have the more talented players individually, and when they're ahead, they're really scary. But without team play, you ain't nothing.
Who do you think has the better individual players?
I would agree with Superhot Crew. I said before as well that I think Superhot Crew would win, but it's not the only point that matters, so it really depends how the other things went out too.
Yeah, we'll see in the rest of the series, of course. Thank you for sending those in. And remember to weigh in before each game with the team you think will win by tweeting @SHGWin or @ROCWin to @LOLEsports. Now we have to take a quick break, but when we come back, the Superhot Crew looks to even up the series in game two. Don't go anywhere.
Counter TP from Zaz coming around, and Roccat are going to try and turn this one around. They manage to catch themselves. There's the knockup, and the first blood for the top lane cow. Now Impaler stuck inside, and the Dragon Pit will go down. That's a one kill once again for the cow. Mimer is going to fall, and now the red pilot, Mr. Alters, joined them, and that's going to be a kill back for them.